Now, from WYDC-TV, this is Big Fox News at 10.
Thanks for joining us. I'm Anna Manuel. Many people see Labor Day weekend as the last true weekend of summer. But with warm temperatures throughout the week, it feels like summer is still going strong. Our Maggie Hall has the latest updates for your Southern Tier Labor Day.
Many families use this holiday weekend to spend time together and enjoy the summer weather while it lasts.
We actually have all of our family coming in. We're over at Juanita Lake.
Yeah.
So we got the family coming in. We're out skiing. Just went down the trail. It was beautiful.
That's awesome.
The weather's great.
Yeah, just looking forward to being out on the lake.
The summer weather is holding on for this week, so do what you can to beat the heat.
Swim or eat ice cream usually always cools me down.
Families enjoyed the fountain in Centennial Park today, and many headed for their pools and for the Finger Lakes region to cool off before school starts up again. With students going back to school this week, here are some safety recommendations for everyone to keep in mind while out. Watch for school zones. Put your phone away while driving. If you're a parent, pick up and drop off your children in designated areas. Try to carpool to keep down the volume of traffic on the road. Watch for children crossing the street and around parked cars. Always stop for school buses and stay alert for warning lights on the road.
There's a new school bus tracking app for Elmira City School District parents to use. The district will use Zonar MyView to allow parents and guardians to track their students' school bus location in real time. Families can set up their accounts with the school access code and their student's ID. For more information, visit the Transportation Department's page on the Elmira City School District's website. September is Suicide Prevention Month. Two upcoming awareness walks are scheduled in the Twin Tiers for September 9th. In Steuben County, the American Foundation for Suicide Prevention will host an Out of the Darkness walk at Mossy Bank Park. Registration will start at 10 a.m. for the free event. Riverfront Park in Sayre is where Valley Walk Against Suicide will take place. It will begin at 11 a.m. Labor Day marks the unofficial end to the summer, and airports across the country are bracing for big crowds through Wednesday. Garrett Tenney has more.
Vivek Ramaswamy marched alongside supporters during a Labor Day parade in Milford, New Hampshire, a state critical to his political future.
It's very important. I think top three in Iowa, top two in New Hampshire, that puts me on a trajectory to be the next president, and we're working to do it. We've been in both states more than any other candidate.
Despite his in-person appearance, Ramaswamy's supporters were outnumbered Monday by marchers loyal to former President Trump.
I'm just here for the barbecue.
Former Vice President Mike Pence stopped in Concord, where a holiday barbecue cook-off was underway.
I'll be honest with you, our life's been pretty good the last couple of years. And it might have been easy to sit this one out, but that's not the way I was raised.
President Biden spent the day with a group that traditionally has lent him strong support, labor union workers.
Folks, in this Labor Day, let me tell you what we're celebrating. We're celebrating jobs, good-paying jobs. Jobs you can raise a family on, union jobs.
But labor strife threatens the economic record Biden is running on. An auto worker strike could be 10 days away without a new contract. Biden said Monday he didn't think it would happen, but union members say a strike remains a possibility.
You know, there's no excuse at the end of this. If we get to the 14th and they haven't delivered, then we got to do what we got to do.
Ongoing Hollywood strikes have networks preparing for a new television season without the actors and writers who are on the picket line. Skyler Henry, CBS News, The White House.
Former Smash Mouth lead singer Steve Harwell has died. The 56-year-old musician, best known for hits like All Star, Walking on the Sun, and I'm a Believer, passed away at his home in Boise, Idaho. He'd been battling medical complications, which forced the frontman to retire 2 years ago. A band manager for Smash Mouth said the cause of death was liver failure. Tributes have been pouring in for the last several days after it was announced that Harwell was in hospice care. Smash Mouth sold over 10 million albums worldwide, topping the charts with two number one hit singles. The next Republican presidential debate is just over 3 weeks away. The field has already narrowed a bit after last month's event in Wisconsin. And as Doug Luzader reports from Washington, we already have an idea of who is going to make it to round two.
The Reagan Presidential Library in Simi Valley, California looks serene enough.
But toward the end of the month, it will be a battleground.
And I am the only non-neocon on this stage.
We saw last month in Milwaukee just how heated the GOP primary fight has gotten. And many of these same candidates are preparing for the next debate in California, having learned some important lessons.
I learned that the more you insult people, the more time you get.
Now, there may be some truth to that, and at the last debate, it was rising candidate Vivek Ramaswamy who took quite a bit of flack and gave it right back.
You have no foreign policy experience, and it shows.
And you know what? I wish you well in your future career on the boards of Lockheed and Raytheon. You know,
and a big question hangs in the air. Will former President Donald Trump take part? He sat out the last one, but he intends to keep his rivals and voters guessing.
Do you anticipate at some point jumping into the debates?
I might. I mean, you know, it's possible. I like debating. I guess I won because of the debates. You know, they've been very good to me. So I might. But at this moment, I'm leading by so much that it seems to be foolish to do it.
Now, this next debate will be on September 27th. The fundraising and polling requirements to get on the stage have tightened since the last debate, so there may be fewer participants, but already a handful of candidates have qualified. In Washington, Doug Luzader, Fox News.
Talk about a field of dreams. Florida's Pensacola Blue Wahoos are offering up their entire ballpark to fans to rent on Airbnb. Renting out the stadium will cost you $5,143 a night. It has two queen beds, four bunk beds, and unlimited ballpark access. That includes the batting cage, on-field practice, clubhouse TVs, ping pong, padded chairs, and even the meal menus. Thousands remain trapped in the Black Rock Desert in Nevada today after monsoon rains and flash flooding turned the Burning Man concert into a muddy mess. Max Gerlach has more.
A line of mud-laden cars expected to pass through Gerlach, Nevada as the day goes on.
It's the end of the world! It's Lord of the Flies!
This is the closest town to the Burning Man Festival, where tens of thousands have been stranded for days after monsoon rains through the weekend led to flash flooding, closing roads around Burning Man and leading to at least one death, which is still under investigation. According to Burning Man organizers, on Monday, they will be opening up routes for people to drive out of the lake bed where the festival is being held. Some have already been able to get out either by vehicle or by walking out, while others are staying in place for now, including Fox News senior correspondent and veteran burner Claudia Cowan.
It's still a fun Burning Man. There are dance parties to be found. Some of the camps are still open, including ours. So we're making the best of it.
Organizers now say mobile cell trailers have been placed around the event. Sanitation trucks are running to ensure portable toilets are clean. And firefighters and EMS workers will now remain on site for two extra days.
People are taking care of each other. We have food. We have provisions. We have shelter. So it's really just kind of a group effort to get through this until the roads dry up.
But the festival will go on. At 9 p.m. tonight, organizers say they'll conduct the annual burning of the giant wooden man. In Gerlach, Nevada, Max Gordon, Fox Weather.
Still ahead, we have your complete forecast. Plus, there's a new tool for people who say they've seen unidentified flying objects to report the sightings to the government. Stay with us.
Now, your Twin Tiers forecast from Big Fox.
Hi, everyone. I'm meteorologist Sam Ryan. As we look at our Memorial Day, lots of sunshine here in Syracuse. Beautiful shot. And we can see in Binghamton also dealing with plenty of sunshine and warm temperatures out there, to say the least. It is going to be a scorcher. As we look at our temperatures, they topped out at 92 degrees. Sunday was 88 degrees. And we're going to stay warm or hot here even into our day Tuesday and Wednesday. Kids going back to school. Maybe you're heading back to work. Find ways to stay cool. We have the heat advisory in effect from noon until 7 p.m. We'll likely have another one on Wednesday, as it's just kind of a carbon copy forecast from our Tuesday. So patchy fog will be possible as we head out the door early on. A heat advisory in effect, so maybe you want to take the dog for a walk. The afternoon may be a little bit too warm for that. Better in the morning or after sunset. Heat indices will be topping out in the mid-90s out there, what it feels like outside, that heat index. Then a cold front moves in this weekend, so the heat won't last forever. We're in that time of the year now. We start to get a little bit bigger swings in the temperatures, and we have a cold front. When we say cold front, it actually means something. And during the heart of the summer, cold front comes through, and it's just, I mean, temperatures might drop a degree. That's about it. Sometimes they even warm up on the backside of a cold front during the summer. But anyway, heat, humidity pouring in here. We have a system moving in from the far west that has the cold front, and out ahead of it, winds out of the south. There's the system here, just kind of show you, moving into the Great Lakes area. So it's this low spinning like this in a counterclockwise direction, scooping up all that moisture, pushing it over us over the next couple days. Then we'll have a chance of thunderstorms developing as we go into the later part of the forecast Thursday and into Friday and into Saturday. Oh, that cold front moving through, and that's going to bring about a big change in the weather. So temperatures around 66 with patchy fog possible out the door, 87 already at noontime, 91 at 5 p.m. And a quick personal recommendation. This is if you can keep your hands cool, you can help keep the body cool. We have a lot of capillaries in the hands, and there's some science there. So it can help kind of work like a radiator. So I always recommend, if you have to, grab some ice cubes or even grab a cold drink. Keep yourself hydrated in the process. 92 degrees out here for a high temperature. That's ambient temperature. Average is 79, well above that. Sunset at 7:35 and sunrise at 6:36 a.m. And as we look at that dew point temperature, it'll stay in those upper 60s. So another heat advisory possible Wednesday with near record high temperatures. Then it cools down into the weekend with thunderstorms possible. Best chance, it looks like here, Friday and into Saturday.